Hey guys, welcome to the second part of my ASCII RPG tutorial. If you haven't seen the first one, I highly recommend it. And also don't forget that you might take part in my challenge. Now let's see where we left off. We have the main menu, the rules, new game, saving, and loading. In today's video, we will give more stats to the player, refine the saving, make the map with its styles, and also make the movement. Okay, let's go! First we want to add the remaining player stats, which are the potion number, elixir number, gold amount, and of course the X and Y coordinates. So this is 7, 8 with the name altogether, but we will include another one in the save function. This is the key boolean contributing to our progress in the game. Now let's include these stats in the saving. Again, don't forget to convert them into strings. Now if we check it, start a new game, then save and quit, the load file will be updated, just like that. The next step is to include these stats in the loading part. Let's go back to the main loop to the choice equals to statement. Again, remember the order and save the list elements as the player stats. Important! To use these variables, you have to convert them back to integers. Otherwise the game will crash. Watch out for the last one, that's a boolean. Now let's see what happens when the file is missing. For this I will rename the loadable file. Yep, file not found. To avoid this, we should make an exception. First, we try to open this file. If it's there, we're good. Otherwise, we should tell the player that there's no such file. For this, you write accept OS error and say there's no loadable file while holding it on the screen with an input. Now, if you check it, you can see it's working. Great, but we should check one more thing. What if there's something wrong with the file, like if your cat takes a nap on your keyboard and part of the information is gone? The file is still there, we can load it, but it's corrupted. Well, that's bad, but we can make it that the game won't crash at least. We need another if statement that checks if the length of the list is the amount that we specified. Right now it's 9. So we make something like just before. Now if we check it, working as intended. If we start a new game, it's refreshed and now perfect. Now let's make the map. We will create tiles and put them together. First, we make a map list that will contain sublists. The number of sublists is equals to the number of rows of your map. And the amount of tiles in one sublist is equals to the number of columns. The first sublist holds the tiles from the first row, the second sublist holds the tiles from the second row, and so on. Identical tiles should have the same name. I already have one map created, so I'll just paste it. Take your time to create one or just copy mine. As you can see, there are 5 rows with the Y coordinate ranging from 0 to 4 and 7 columns with the X value ranging from 0 to 6. Altogether, there are 35 tiles on this map, but you can create as many as you want. You can see the layout having plains, mountains, it has a town and the boss cave. You can change these to your liking. Now let's make the borders. Vertically, the map is 5 tiles big. This is exactly the length of the map list. But since we're gonna use this YLAN as the limit index, we should withdraw one from it, so the Y value won't reach 5. Otherwise, we would get an index error. Same goes for the XLAN value with the length of any sublist. So now YLAN and XLAN are 4 and 6. If we check this exact tile from the map list, it's the 7th item of the 5th sublist since list indices range from 0. If we don't withdraw one from any of these, we get the index error. Now let's make the biome dictionary that holds all information about the tiles. It's very useful since we can attach multiple stuff to the key. These keys will be the tile names that we used in the map list. The first one is the plains. Let's include other keys within this one. I'll name the first one T as text and the second one E as enemy. This will tell the game if mobs can spawn on the tile or not. Now again, I have the full dictionary already, feel free to pause the video to make yours. As you can see, I have 10 different tiles and enemies can spawn on the plains, woods, bridge, mountain and hills. Now we have the map set up, let's check where we are. We get the tile key this way. Since we're at 0,0, the location is the plains. Now with this key we can check the name of the tile if we ask for its T key. Same goes for the other key. Easy as that. Now let's make our play loop. We should print all necessary information to the screen. First, the location with our fresh list and dictionary. Looking great. Let's sit in the terminal for a second. Nice. Now we print the stats of the player. The first one goes like this, The rest are a copy-paste for me. Yeah, and almost forgot, we should make a max HP stat too. Don't forget that you can only add strings to each other, so you should convert the integers. Okay, let's see. Now it's starting to look like an actual game. Cool. The last thing for this video is the movement. There are two kinds of movement for these games, open and closed borders. I'll use the last one, but I'll show you the other first. Let's make the directions. 1 is up, 2 is right, 3 is down, 4 is left. Great. Let's code the actual movement. So if we type 1, we should go up, meaning we lower the y value with 1. But only if we are not at the edge, if the y is bigger than 0. If you want open borders, we can make it that we pop up on the other side of the map. I'll show it to the other way as well. If we go down, the y will be increased, but only if we are not at the edge. If we are, the y is set to 0. Again, open borders. Just to see where we are, I'll print the coordinates. Let's check it. If we go up, we pop up at the bottom. Great. And if we go down, working as intended. Nice. I'll stick to the closed borders, but you don't have to, it's up to you. So now the same goes to the x values. If you work with closed borders, you should print the directions only if you are allowed to go there, meaning you're not on the edge for the specific location. Now we can code these if statements. And we should check it. Since we are at 0, 0, we can only go to the right and down. I wanted to go up, but I can't, since I coded that right. Same with left. We can play around, and if you followed my instructions, your game should work like this too. Okay now, quick recap. We implemented more stats, printed them out in the play loop, made the map and the movement, and also now we have a pretty good saving system. Hope you enjoyed the video. Next time we create some enemies, implement fighting, and use some potions. Hopefully see you tomorrow. Stay safe and take care.